Seven decades of innovative design came after a childhood with dyslexia for an architect who, they say, couldn't draw two lines together as a boy. But Richard Rogers' contribution to architecture and urbanism is woven into some of the most famous buildings around us.
Because he was a charming man by all accounts, somebody who listened, who, you know, who was open to conversations and so on, his ideas sort of fed into the wider view of what London could be.
When it came to marking 1,000 years in the capital, it was Rogers' vision that arched over London. The Millennium Dome, or as it's now called, the O2 Arena, just another of the Anglo-Italian's contributions to the city's skyline. He was also the architect behind the Lloyd's of London building, Heathrow's Terminal 5, and the so-called cheesegrater. In Paris, his Pompidou Centre was described as pedagogical. In Cardiff, his vision for an open and transparent parliamentary building is on full display at the Welsh Senedd.
I think it's actually a reflection of the period that we live in. We always say, you know, buildings have a much longer life than the activity inside.
Richard Rogers took home some of the highest accolades in architecture and design. And today, he's remembered for revolutionising and transforming monuments into popular places of social and cultural exchange. A high-tech pioneer. Less an architect, they say, more a catalyst. Sadia Chowdhury, Sky News, in London.